Hey everybody, Mark Michaels here with Performance Hall Central, joined today with Mr. Brandon Westfall. Brandon, welcome.
Thanks for having me.
So we're here to talk about NCHA Non-Pro Horse of the Year for 2021. Fiddle and Steel, your horse. That was quite a year you guys had.
Yes, sir. Yeah, it was a pretty amazing year, and that's an amazing horse, and it was a pretty cool accomplishment for sure.
So Metallic Cat out of one of your homebred horses, a little bit reckless.
Yes, sir.
Started it off with the Non-Pro Futurity Championship last year, 227. Went down to the Cattlemen's last spring, marked a 222 for the Non-Pro Derby Championship there. NCHA Super Stakes, 225.5 to take home the Non-Pro Championship there. And then the Breeders' Invitational, 225. And then multiple other Non-Pro finalists, quite a year. Tell us sort of about, you know, what some of the things that you like most about that horse.
That horse really has everything. I can't really falter anything he doesn't do. He's so strong, he's so physical, he's so smart, he has a great presence about him, he's so cowy. I mean, he has everything you kind of want in one. I mean, he's one of them, one in a millions. They're hard to find. I mean, he's the best horse I've ever rode, and it's probably gonna be that case for a long time, maybe forever. but
well, you've traditionally, you know, come and showed in the Non-Pro, and that's been your focus, and then you've shown some in the limited opens as well. But on this horse, you made some open semi-finals and finals. You marked a 223 in the wild card at the BI, made the open finals at the Summer Spectacular. You didn't get the third jewel in the Triple Crown, but you made the open semis there. So that horse, I mean, what was the difference there, being able to have a horse that was, you know, competitive in the open side as well?
Oh, it was pretty awesome, because I feel like it's really hard for a horse anyway showing all the time, but that horse going in the open and non-pro, and he handled it really good. But it was really cool getting to show him. Me being a non-pro, everybody knows you're going against the best guys in the world, and it's extremely tough. And I was fairly successful at some of the shows on him, so that was pretty awesome.
Well, successful enough to win Non-Pro Horse of the Year, so I think you did pretty good. So tell us a little bit about, obviously, Mum and Dad, big role models for you, Russ and Janet. Nobody works harder than those two, especially your mother. I know how much she puts into the program there. What did it mean for your family, for you to accomplish this?
Oh, it was awesome. I owe everything to them. They've taught me everything I know. They've helped me in every way they possibly can. And they've always got my back, and they're 100% all every day, all the time. So it was a pretty cool accomplishment for the whole family and for the horse.
Yeah. Well, obviously this is a team sport. Even though it's just the one guy competing, there's a lot of other people behind the scenes and in the arena helping you achieve these goals. Who are some of the people you'd like to thank for this?
I mean, like I said before, I'd like to thank my parents first and foremost for everything they do for me. And Morgan Cromer's there all the time for me. Casey Green helped me a lot this year. Clint Allen, Boyd Rice, Lloyd Cox helped me quite a bit this year. There's too many to name, but that's a few to name off. I'm sure I'm forgetting somebody, but I just want to thank everybody that's there for me, and I appreciate it.